Hi guys, it's Monika. I am going to, I guess you could call this a what's in my trash type of a video, but you know what, I never have like a ton of trash. So when I like watch other ladies that do their trash videos, they're like these big pretty buckets actually, but they get these buckets full of stuff. I never get that way. So I have a few things to share with you. So I like to call it the best of my trash and a little bit of a chitty chat and some things that are going on, I guess. So today is actually St. Patrick's Day, and Jay and I have been sick ever since we came home. We came home from Texas and we started to feel poorly. We had my mom's birthday party, and it was the following day, that Monday, that we really started to feel bad. And then by Tuesday, Wednesday, we were down for the count. We both still had to work. I had to teach classes, but we've been dragging all week. And today, I feel pretty decent today, although I'm still very foggy and things of that nature. But you know, we've been taking decongestants and trying to clear our brains and function a little bit better. So I thought I would just share with you a couple of things that are in my trash, and I'm going to start with hair care because many of you know I've been on a quest for hair. Now, I don't know if there's going to be a tried and true hair regrowth method for anyone or something that's going to work for everyone, but I've tried a number of different things, and one of the things that I've tried, I think it was Laura from Makeup Shake Up, I'm not too sure, I'll have to look it up, but this, I believe, in Elle's Living, I think both of them have used this and have really raved about this product. So I've been using this for quite a while now. This is empty, and this is my replacement, my second bottle of it. I also use the conditioner, and I also use the serum. So have I noticed a tremendous amount of difference? Yeah or no, my hair feels good, it feels healthy. I'm not seeing the massive fallout in the drain. I do think sometimes that, you know, my hairdresser says my hair feels thicker, looks thicker. She's seeing a little bit of regrowth, but nothing major, nothing like everyone else has been really talking about. So I have been using this in the conditioner and the serum. The serum I use twice a day. I'm all done. I've gone through several bottles of the serum. This is the one I'm just starting now, but I've gone through several bottles of this because I use this twice a day. So I also dermaroll my scalp. I dermaroll my scalp one night a week. That's about what the average is. And then I will put this on after dermarolling as well. I think if anything, the serum is going to make the difference. So I like this enough. I've noticed enough of a difference in my hair to rebuy it. And that to me is huge. And until something else comes along that someone says, oh, you gotta try this, this is gonna really work, I'm sticking with this because it has worked. The other thing I've just replaced is, and this took me a long time to empty this guy out, but mainly because I'm not really hung up on facial cleansers, because I figure whatever you put on your skin, if it feels good, if it has decent ingredients, and then it's only on there for a moment, you're washing it off or you're triple cleansing or whatever. So it never stays on a long time. It's taken me a long time to go through this because I buy all sorts of different things in TJ Maxx. I see something that sounds interesting that I like, I try it. So but I like this enough that I replaced it with the whole a brand new bottle. This works really good for me, for my skin. Some people have said that they feel a little burning sensation. I don't. But this is the hydrating facial cleanser for normal to dry skin. And that's really what I need. I have more dry skin than anything. The other thing that I finally finished, and I already have my replacement. I actually won my replacement. So I finally finished. This is the second bottle of this that I've gone through since I've been turned on to this from Natalie the Beauty Diva. And this is the Body Mary Glycolic Acid. I love washing my face with this and have bought this twice. This one I won in a giveaway from A Life with Lily, Sheila's channel. And she sent it to me. So I was absolutely thrilled because I knew this was a product that I used, have repurchased, and really like. The other thing that I finally finished was my rosehip seed oil. Now, I've been using rosehip seed oil for a while, But I've also been using the, I wanted to finish the organic, the ones that I bought, and I finally finished this completely. And I have also tried the rosehip seed oil from The Ordinary, and I really like this, but I wanted to finish this out before I really tackled this completely. So what I do is I use rosehip seed oil on my neck and down into my décolletage area, the neck area, the chest area. I usually put a dropper on the palm of my hands and I mix it with my weakest Retin-A, my 0.2, 0.25, and I mix it all up. And yes, rosehip seed oil is vitamin A, as is Retin-A, but I mix it all up and I just put it all the way down to my neck, to my chest area. And I do this every single night. So I really like rosehip seed oil or cacao oil. So whichever one you like, think about putting it on your neck. You don't have to mix it with Retin-A. Just because I do it doesn't mean it's gonna work for you, but that's what I do. So I replaced it, I have it, I like it. The other thing I finally ran out of is my Matrixyl Sync 6 Serum from Timeless, and I knew I was running low. So when they had their 50% off, I bought the big bottle of it. I am not going to buy the Matrixyl 3000 anymore. I'm just gonna stick to the Matrixyl Sync 6. I really, really like this. I think it works well for my skin. I'm not gonna bother with the other, any of the others. I still do use The Ordinary's Buffet, but I'm not too sure that I'm going to buy it when I'm finally done, because I really like my Timeless. My two Timelesses, my vitamin C plus E plus folic acid, and my Matrixyl, and of course my hyaluronic acid. So that's what I, you know, what I have. And the other thing that I've finally almost done, to the point where I had to go and buy my replacement. This is my Boots number 7 Lift and Luminate. I bought the replacement in wheat color. I opened up the wrong way. I bought my replacement in the wheat color because this is a perfect color match for me. I never would have figured that, but it's a perfect color match for me. And summer and all of that, I think, is coming, although with a 2 feet of snow outside, who knows, you know. But so I bought this as a replacement. I do all winter and I fall, I have mixed it with a lighter shade to lighten it up for the off season. But I know it's getting low, so I wanted to replace it. So I got my replacement. The other thing that I wanted to mention that was not in my trash, but about a month ago, I had finished up doing the Lash Tonic. I tossed it, but I had done a collaboration, a comparison collaboration with Carol from the O'Carroll Show, and one of the things that I noticed in that when we're using the Lash Tonic, I wasn't seeing any growth. I wasn't seeing any, you know, quick, they say in 2 weeks you're gonna notice this and that. So I didn't see any of that. So I've been using this product called Blinq, which you will remember if you watched that video. I'll link that video. This was sent to me. I am a CarePost user. I've used my CarePost. I love my CarePost. CarePost has done wonders for my lashes. I thought that I would give it a break when I ran out of CarePost and I tried Lash Tonic. Lash Tonic was an epic fail. About that same time, I got contacted by this company called Blinq, and they offered to send me, no obligation, 5 free little bottles of this to try. And without an obligation, I said, sure. So I've tried it. So it has been almost 5 weeks, still early. But I can honestly tell you that in that 5 week period, I have noticed that, I mean, normally I have like these rogue lashes that shoot up and I have to trim them. I've actually trimmed my eyelashes before I even started my Lash Tonic. But what I've noticed is that all the shorter lashes are all growing long. And the other thing that I've noticed is that when I take my mascara off, which you're not going to see, by the way, but when I take my mascara off, I think my eyelashes are slightly darker. Now, I have very blonde eyelashes, very blonde eyelashes. I think they're slightly darker. So far, 5 weeks into this, this is reacting to me just like I believe CarePost would have. And so I think they're the same type of ingredients. You can check it out. I'll link the website. But I'm really pleased with the response of, with how my eyelashes have been responding to this. I think that's pretty cool. So I'm going to continue on with this. I'm going to take some pictures, close-up pictures of my eyes and do a full report. But a lot of you have asked how it's going, and I just want to tell you I'm really pleased with it so far. The other thing I wanted to mention, as many of you know, we went to Texas, and I will tell you, Texas was amazing. I was really surprised. Now, we only went to San Antonio. We did the Riverwalk. We did a bunch of different things there, you know, the Alamo, things of that nature. I was really surprised at how clean the city was. The Riverwalk was immaculate. And even the streets, the city streets that we walked on in that area, they were all really clean. I'm sure there were areas that were probably not, but we didn't see any like graffiti, any garbage hanging around, anything like that. I was like really amazed at the condition of the city. And one night we went to a rodeo. I know, Texas, a rodeo. Many of you probably have done rodeos and you know all about it, but I've never been to a real life rodeo. And so I was kind of excited. You know, they were also seeing a concert, Little Big Horn, Little Big House, three. I can't remember the name of the band, but I'll link it. And it's a country band. And so I was like really super excited about seeing cowboys in real life, I guess. But in the rodeo, there were these front row seats, and we thought, wow, cool, we can sit front row, we'll get really good views, blah, blah, blah. Well, little did we know that, yeah, you could just about pat the rump of the horse going by, not the cowboy, but of the horse going by, you're that close. But little did we know or expect that when they really got going, they were gonna shoot up stuff from the ground. And so I got sprinkled. And so I swear, I was sniffing it. I think it was mixed with you know what. So my rodeo experience at front row seats was not the best. And the other thing that really cracked me up, every time we went on an Uber ride or we talked to anyone, they all remarked on my accent. And everyone pegged me as a Yankee from up north, you know, and from Boston and all that stuff. And I thought that was really hysterical because, oops, I don't hear the accent. I think they all had an accent. So yeah, people talked a little slower. They walked a little slower. Life seemed to be a little bit more calmer, but, and they all thought I had an accent. But hey, it was a fun trip. I didn't like getting horse dung splattered at me. Pretty sure there was dung mixed into that. And I really have mixed feelings about the rodeo in general, but I'll save that for another time. But it was just a really, really fun trip. Now, if Jay and I can get healthy, I'll tell you, getting sick, I think we probably caught someone's germs on the airplane ride. That's what I think. But hey guys, thanks so much. Again, I apologize for my best of my trash being such a small amount, but I just don't go through a lot of products, I guess. So that's it, guys. Thanks so much. Please like the video, leave me a comment, and if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe to the channel. I truly appreciate it. Oh, and you can also share me around. That wouldn't be a bad idea if you share me to Twitter or to anything of that nature. I would really, really like that a lot. Bye, guys.